हेलो माय डियर स्टूडेंट्स, गुड मॉर्निंग एवरीबॉडी। आई एम उज्ज्वल कुमार हलदार, लेक्चरर इन इंग्लिश, गवर्नमेंट सोराबजी कॉलेज, प्रेसपुर। टुडे आई वांट टू टेक ए क्लास ऑन इंग्लिश फर्स्ट पेपर फॉर द स्टूडेंट्स ऑफ क्लास 11 एंड 12। Already, I have written something on the board. That means, written the name of the unit, lesson, and topic. Unit 5, lesson 3, topic crafts at our time. Please open your textbook and try to follow me. Try to follow me. In the text, at the very beginning of the text, you will find two questions. Can you distinguish between art and craft? Before going to discuss this topic, we shall try to have an idea over craft and art, or art and craft. Can you distinguish between art and craft? Yes, we can, or I can, and you can also. I can distinguish between art and craft. For art, as for example, we can say folk music. Already, we have read the text on folk music. That means Unit 5, Lesson 2. In my previous two classes, I discussed folk music. So, folk music is an example of art. But pottery is an example of craft. Pottery is an example of craft. Art is the making or study of paintings, drawings, etc., or the object created, while craft is an activity in which you make something using a lot of your skills, especially with your hands. With your hands. So, from this sentence, you may get the idea about art and craft. What is art? Art is the making or study of paintings, drawing, etc. Whereas craft is an activity. What is craft? Craft is an activity in which someone makes something using a lot of skills, especially with his or her hands. Second question, how many different crafts do rural people engage in now? What do these have to do with their lives? Rural people engage in many different crafts like woodcrafts, jewelry, embroidery, etc. These crafts have to do a lot with their lives. First, they earn their livelihood. They earn their livelihood by engaging themselves in these crafts. There are a lot of peoples in rural Bangladesh, that means in the village, where they earn their livelihood through crafts. Secondly, these crafts meet their psychological hunger because they utilize their creative power investing in those crafts. Not only that, the people of our country who are engaged in crafts, they also engage themselves in these professions or crafts, particularly for meeting of their psychological hunger or mental hunger. Okay, now we will try to read the text, read it out the text, and you will follow me. Please open your textbook and stay with me till the end of the class. A craft is an applied form of art, a social and cultural product reflecting the inclusive nature of folk imagination. So, try to read or follow the beginning sentence very carefully and mindfully. What has been told in this sentence, we will try to grasp it or understand it. Here, a craft work is an applied form of art. So, from the very beginning sentence, we can easily say that a craft work is an art. And what type of art? Applied form of art. Applied means practical. Applied means practical. Practical or pragmatic, or we can say pragmatic. TIC. Pragmatic form of arts. A social and cultural product. So, three things are related with a craft work. At the very beginning sentence, it has been told clearly that a craft work is an applied form of art. So, we have got three ideas: applied form of art. Second one, a social and cultural product. What type of product is it? Social and cultural. It's okay. Reflecting. And what does it reflect? What does a craft work reflect? Yes, it reflects the inclusive nature of folk imagination. So, from the very beginning sentence, we can derive three things: applied form of art, social and cultural product. Next, or the third one is inclusive nature of folk imagination. Understand? Yes. A craft work, and if I asks you question, what is a kraftwerk and what does it reflect, then you will write the answer of these questions from this very beginning line of your textbook. It's okay. A kraftwerk which usually doesn't bear the signature of its maker. There are a lot of kraftwerks in our country, and we become very surprised or wonder at its. We wonder at that aesthetic beauty, or we marvel at their beauty, but this very beautiful crafts work never bear the signature of its of their makers. Retains a personal touch, and it doesn't. A crafter doesn't keep. Retain means sustain or keep up. Retain means sustain or keep up. It doesn't keep up or sustain a personal touch. When we look at a 30-year-old nakshikhata, we wonder at its motifs and design that point to the artistic ingenuity and presence and the presence of the maker in it. Artistic. Here, the word artistic. Artistic means decorative, means decorative, and ingenuity. Creativity or inventiveness. Understand? So, when you look at a 30-year-old nakshikhata, we wonder at its motif and designs. Actually, nakshikhatas are usually found in the rural area, and also it is available all over the country. And already this craft has earned the fame and name all over the world. All over the world. But we don't know who are the makers of this fine artistic craft. The fact is that we don't know her name, who is the maker of this beautiful craft or this beautiful nakshikhata. We don't know the name of its maker or any other details. Or we never try to find out the details of that person who is the maker of this fine craft. About her, other details about her doesn't take anything away from our appreciation of the artist. Actually, we become surprised at the beauty of nakshikhata, and we usually appreciate or praise the beauty of nakshikhata, but we never think of its maker, or we never show our interest or curiosity to know about the details of its maker. This is universally true. She may belong to a common family, simple family, or poor family. Indeed, the intimate nature of the katha and the tactile feeling it generates. Tactile feelings. Tactile means touchable or tangible. Tactile means touchable or tangible. So, indeed, the intimate nature of the katha and the tactile feeling and the tactile feeling, touchable feeling, it generates. It generates means it creates, animate the work and make it very inviting. Animate the work and make it very inviting. Inviting means very attractive, appealing, very attractive. A craft work is shaped by the interaction of individual creativity and community aesthetics, utility functions, and human values. And if I ask you how a craft work is shaped, how is a craft work shaped, then you will simply tell me that a craft work is shaped by the interaction. How? By the interaction of individual creativity and community aesthetics. Two things are amalgamated or interacted. And what are those two things? Individual creativity and community aesthetics. When these two things are amalgamated or mingled, then a fine craft work is created, is produced. Okay. Utility functions. At the same time, we have to consider what the maker of the craft work has to consider, the utility functions of a crafter and human values. So, from this line, we get four things. What are those? Individual creativity, community aesthetics, utility functions, and human values for shaping a craft work. An artist or the creator of or the producer of a craft work must keep in mind these four things. And what are those? Individual creativity, community aesthetics, the utility functions, and human values. When all these things are amalgamated or mingled, then a nice or fine craft work is shaped. It is distinguished by its maker's desire to locate himself or herself in the wider and ever-changing cultural aspirations of the community and subsequently of the market. Here, this line is also important. It is distinguished. How is it distinguished? By its maker's desire to locate himself or herself in the wider and ever-changing cultural aspirations. This term is important, ever-changing. That means always changing. Ever-changing cultural aspiration of the community and subsequently of the market. But even when the market is an important factor, community aesthetics remains the factor determining the form and content of the craft work. Even when the market is an important factor, community aesthetics remains the factor determining. So, community factor always determines the form and content of the craft work, of a craft work. The exquisite terracotta dolls from Dinajpur. Where? From where? Dinajpur. It's okay. Dating back to early 1940s, that formed a part of the Bangladesh National Museum's collection were mostly bought from village fairs by some patron. Patron means buyers. Buyers. Or customers or client. They were no doubt meant to be consumer items, but the dolls reflect community aesthetics. Though they were consumer items, but the dolls reflect community aesthetics in such a manner that the market has not been able to impose its own preference on them. Okay, in my next class, I will take another class on this topics and take preparation for the next class. Thank you all. Today I like to stop here. Thank you all.